I know. Could you tell everyone else your name, even though we know your name?
I am Aries.
Hello.
So I made it my mission to beat every cast member from the Overwatch team. Give them art. But my question to you, because I think this would be a great idea, I would like to see all of you cosplay eventually the character that you're voice acting. And I would like to ask you, have you considered cosplaying as Sombra and also as Symmetra?
Yes.
100%.
However, I don't want to speak for the other voice actors. If they don't want to, I don't know. But I know that we would love to. But because we are the voices, it's something that I think we would do with Blizzard, just because it's, I'm not going to walk around like, Sombra, be a weirdo. But I will. Yeah, I would like to do it with our mother company.
Like a police call?
Perhaps, yes. That would be a great idea. I've told them, so let them work on it. I'll see.
So, my name, Diego Candelaria. Pleased to meet you all. I'm a huge fan of Overwatch ever since I saw it. I was actually a big Nintendo fan, but I went to PC just to play Overwatch. And currently I only have 500 hours of my life spent in that game. I'm not afraid to say it. Still in gold, but... So, nice to meet you. My question is, what's your favorite character besides the one you voice? What other character do you like or do you play as?
Oh. I want to hug you like big fuzzy Siberian bear.
of the ladies, I'm torn between Sombra and Anna. I want to be Anna when I grow up. But I want to be Sombra now. Like, I kind of want to have that edge. And then of the men, I do. It's also so I can say, I'm not going to kill you. All the time, apparently really low. And then for the men, I really love Hammerdo! I want that voice to come out this, and I will be, oh, let's bring it down!
So do you hang out a lot with John?
I hate Johnny. He's not fun. He's not funny. He's not good looking.
He's not good looking.
He's a ton of fun, yes.
Would you say cringy fun?
Cringy fun?
Cringe, yeah.
Yeah, let's talk about this word. No, I'm serious. It's on the line, often.
On the
world wide webs. And so, explain it to me. I think I'm too old for you gamer kids who use the word. It's like, you like it, but you're like, ill, or what's the deal?
Or is it straight up ill?
Like, he just says really bad puns, and you're like, oh.
But you love him for it.
Yes, but you love him for it.
So is cringy
kind of like your dad?
Yes.
Like, not your dad, but like, I'm your dad. Yes, I'd be awesome. I have great jokes, and totally super awesome. Sorry about that. Like, perhaps one's dad, when one is a teenager, and he makes a joke, and you love him so much, you're like, ooh, dad.
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
Okay. But it's fun. So no, I see what you're saying, but no, I wouldn't use that word. But okay, I'm glad that we've discovered the meaning of cringe.
We are learning so many things.
Thank you. The more we know.
Thank you for your time.
So as you come forward, you need to say hi. My name is Carolina Ravassa, and I'm a gamer. No, introduce yourself. And...
Hi. I'm nervous. Hi. My name, too complicated, is Sunfire. Call me Izzy.
Izzy.
My name is Izzy.
I'm a gamer. Not in shame. Proudly.
I'm a gamer.
Yes.
Oh man, I love you guys so much. I'm sorry. My question for you is actually, what would you do if you had your character's abilities?
I would go invisible and bother all my friends. I would teleport all over the world. Can you imagine how much I would get done?
Oh my god,
I've always wanted, since I was a little kid, when people would be like, hey, what superhero power do you want? My teleportation would be amazing.
I can go visit my friends here, and I can go visit my mom, and I can go do this, and I can go do that, and never have to stop, ever, 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 except maybe just to sleep for a little tiny bit of time.
The airlines vacation.
And not have coffee.
The airlines
vacation. Honestly, though, I would hack the president.
I'm a Twitch streamer in Puerto Rico. My name is Zachariox.
Follow me.
Follow Zachariox.
Just starting out. But anyway, I usually ask a similar question to other voice actors over the years, but I kind of modify some Titor, mostly known for Sombra and Symmetra. Would you want them to be like actual friends in real, like if they somehow turn into reality and, oh my god, they're my best friends, would you want them? And if so, why?
Friend. I want Kevin to be my best friend.
I know.
Symmetra would be interesting. I actually think I really enjoy spending time with her because she's so direct and because I feel like she's a no-nonsense person, and she also has a tremendous, her moral compass is very strong. Whether or not, you know, we know that there's a question of whether or not she's with the right people. But we also do know that she's very interested in building a better world, and that's her main focus in life is to make the world a better place. And so I think she would be a really aspirational person to be around.
I just thought you were asking if they would be friends.
No. Like, if for some reason, like, Sombra came to life, and all of a sudden, always.
Heck yeah. Both of them. I think they both have, like, she has a really elegant way of dissing people. Yeah. You were not meant for greatness.
Did you insult me? Because it sounded really nice, but then you insulted me.
And Sombra's just making fun of people. So I think they would be funny people to hang out with because they're dark.
Our girl band would be hot.
Yeah! She's got the Beyonce vibe.
I've already got the name for our girl band with Widowmaker and everything.
Tickles? The Queens of Shade. Yes.
Thank you.
I wish we had that much power. We don't. Hey, Jeff. So I've been thinking about this band. Okay, bye, Jeffy.
And then Sombra, she's so amazing. And my question is, what are your favorite qualities of your character and what do you dislike about them?
My favorite quality, my very favorite quality about Symmetra, and I alluded to it just a little bit now already, is that despite her circumstances, whether her history, which was not particularly happy, her background being plucked out of the slums away from her family, being taken to Vishkar, all of that stuff, and also her personal abilities or obstacles, she still maintains a constant focus on wanting to do things and be forward moving and making the world a better place rather than using those obstacles as reasons to quit or reasons to give up. When it was confirmed that she was on the spectrum, it only made me more excited, and I think a lot of other people more excited to see someone who didn't look at that or didn't in any way register that as something that was to stop her. If anything, there's a great line in the comic that she says, where she says, "It used to bother me when people would ask where I was on the spectrum. Now it doesn't because I know I can do things that other people can't." And that right there, that force of nature that she is, that is something that I love about her. As far as things I don't like about her, I personally would love her to be a little bit warmer, like if I were hanging out with her. But again, it's part of what makes her is that she is so direct and she is so no nonsense. And that she does say not very nice things as a matter of fact, as opposed to meaning to be.
Yes.
Sombra. I said this earlier, I love her dark sense of humor. I think it's a great way to make fun of things without really being such a horrible human being. I also admire her struggle in life. She played Puerto Rico, going through this right now, and in the last 8 months. She grew up in a fictitious Mexico, right? And women and children were being killed, and she had to transform herself to come out on top and survive. And now, you know, now she's the Sombra we know. But I think that she's had to overcome a really dark past and lost a lot of her loved ones. I think that's why she's also so guarded. So I think that, you know, she's come out on top, and that's something I admire. I mean, I think she's rad. I don't know if there's anything I don't like about her.
I don't like that she's not real. I want her to be real.
Somebody once said that she was a little bit arrogant because she always thinks she knows best. I don't see it that way, but if we were to turn it that way, okay, maybe she's always like, I know better than you. So, you know, I don't particularly like arrogance, but I think that she's just badass. So.
Thank you.
Are you okay?
I'm
okay.
Yes.
Do you need healing?
I am Benji. I need healing.
I put lots of wonders in God for you, darling, so.
Understandable. Shield generator will be nice, though.
I just have the health packs.
Thank you. I'll try to move quickly as when the teleporters are up. And hello, I'm Andres. I'm online, I guess. Andres online.
Andres online. Sombra online.
Yes. Figa. I'm a gamer. I had a question, but then somebody asked this question very similar to that. Now I'm trying to process this. So, in terms of determining voice or lore or anything, how much input do you guys have? And if I may know, if there is enough,
how much do we bring to the characters, or how much do we?
Yes, thank you.
I wish I could say that I invented Sombra or all these wonderful things, but for now I just lent the voice. Yes, I've known how to hack into her, way of saying things to make fun of people in a snarky sort of way. I think that I connect to that. So that's a lot of me bringing it to the role, but I haven't made up voice lines or I haven't aided in any of her design or anything. I wish in the future maybe. So no, for now not much. But I know that May's line, sorry, you know, that was her actually saying sorry while she was recording because she was worried her English wasn't great, which is so cute of her. Yolanda is just adorable. And so they were like, keep recording, that's great, and they turned that into May's voice line. But it was actually just the actress saying that. So those things are really awesome that they do, but Sombra, not yet.
Yeah. And the only input that I can remember having was when we first recorded some of the Hindi lines, and I just threw in, and I don't want to tell you which ones they are, because they may or may not have already made it into the game, and they may or may not in the future, but there are certain lines where I was like, oh, this is kind of a standard thing that I would say here, or whatever, so we threw a few of those in just to have them for flavor. I think most of the things, like she mentioned with Yolanda and with May, most of the things that they've taken were more like they saw something and were inspired to put that in, rather than us coming in with an idea, it speaks more to their inspiration than to their creativity, you know, because it's the same thing on television or in film or in play. The director's eye is the eye that sometimes can pluck things out that you don't necessarily see in yourself. So they did that with Winston. Crispin has glasses, and there was a moment when Crispin took off his glasses and put them on and did it a certain way, and they loved it so much that they used him as the prototype for Winston dealing with his glasses as much as he does. So
Winston, he was also recording a lot before Winston was fully designed, so they were still adding stuff, but a lot of us came in later when the character was more designed.
I was gonna say something. Oh, I have definitely suggested that they throw in a chancleta situation. Like some of them, oh, really? Or, you know, I'll show, throw a chancleta.
Totally,
exactly. Or I also explained the because you know, we'll work with the healing. We'll see. But that's something that it's not like I'm gonna be like, yo, Michael, write this down. But I throw it out in case somebody on the interwebs picks it up. Guys, I know there is a super long line, so I wanna get to all the questions, so maybe let's try and keep them short-ish. Not that they've been long, but I realize that we're taking our time too, so.
Hi, my name is Chen, I'm a gamer and a work in progress voice actor. I've worked a lot when it comes to the business of voice acting. But is there a moment that your character, you start developing the idea that you want nothing more to make them better or make them feel like they're just still part of you, and you feel like you can still be them even when you're not in, in the booth and they're just making the voice?
So is there a turning point when you feel like you've embodied the character so much that you sort of carry it into your real life?
Precisely, because I remember there was a clip when Catalina was with Matthew Mercer, and that small clip they were just having a drink, and it just feels like Matthew just fell off on one shot, and she was like, ah, pobrecito.
That was real. That was absolutely real.
I think any role that you play, whether voice acting or not, if you're living with it for a long period of time, it starts to seep into your own consciousness. You know, Katarina was mentioning that after her first BlizzCon, she went to bed and she couldn't stop dreaming about BlizzCon. And I think that happens with any character that you live with or any kind of lifestyle that you live with for a long period of time, that it starts to seep in. I find myself using Symmetra's lines in traffic all the time.
You're crazy.
Yes, well, that's a side note. But I hear, you know, it's like if you learn a new word and then you hear it a lot everywhere all of a sudden because you've learned this new vocabulary word, I think that happens a lot with your character too. They just seep into your consciousness. So it's not a specific turning point so much as the more you're with them, the more they're with you.
Yeah, we obviously want to keep improving the character and digging deeper, like I want to understand Sombra better for my future recording sessions, but for now I wouldn't say that, you know, it's something I can't separate from, but I do enjoy thinking like, hacking the president, or whatever, you know? So I think for the sake of comedy sometimes, you know, I have opened the bomb, you know, like, so stuff like that I think we joke with, but for the most part I think we're our own human beings.
And I do think that's part of the skill as an actor, is knowing how to shut it off, because that, I think a lot of people do get into trouble when they can't. So that's another thing.
Oh, hello!
Yeah.
Great cosplay.
It's glad to be here, though.
Go hack him, go hack him.
You did a great tanning job.
Oh,
my God.
Oh, it's one of my
favorite
games. I play in the White House all day long.
This guy's good.
I want to ask you something. And I noticed that Norwich, the whole cast character is pretty fun, but there's some more characters for you. I know, like, you know, I like a Torbjorn or a Smetra. Oh. But
I want to stand up routine happening right now.
Okay.
I love it. Mr. President, what's your question?
Okay. What character do you despise the most?
Spies.
Yes, you hate. The fool hate.
No, I mean, this sounds stupid, but no, I don't hate any character. Maybe I don't know him well enough to be like, I hate them. Like, you guys play all day, so you're like, oh, I hate them, somebody kills me, because EMP activated. But I don't think I'm like, what? I hate them all. Also, because we know the voice actors, so.
And also, the great thing about this game is that if you do hate any one character, like someone comes up to me and says, oh, I hate the character in the game, like, awesome, there are 26 other characters to kill her with. Have at it. Have fun. Like, something for everyone, yo. So, yeah, so that we, and also with the digital shorts, all the backstory, all of them, even the ones that are quote unquote maybe evil aligned or whatever, all of them make sense as human beings. So you can't really hate them.
Okay, thank you for your time. And I'm not even warning you, you're saying.
Yeah. Very happy.
You have done 4 cosplays in 2 days, is that correct? 3. Okay, 3.
Okay, so 4 cosplays in 3 days.
Doing this because we voice these characters and Blizzard is our mother company. So like suggesting things like this I don't feel comfortable with necessarily.
I want to find out some best teddy bear's name.
And I just want to find out, I keep slipping into her accent. I just want to find out how Symmetra is connected with the rest of the Overwatch, Blackwatch, all of them, because right now she's kind of an island unto herself. And there's only a little bit of interaction with Lucio and a couple of lines here and there in the game. But I'm very interested in finding out what happens with Vishkar globally.
And I think we all want to hear more of their backstories. You know, I think I want to learn more about Widowmaker. And so the more we can find out through the short films or a series that we would love to happen, that would be amazing. You know, that would be long. That's kind of what we're aiming at in terms of like, our dreams. So thank you. Hello, check out her sombra hair! Yes!
Oh, yeah! So, thank you for coming here. I just wanted to tell you that Overwatch actually helped me deal with taking care of my dad. He passed away recently. But yeah, my name is Sally, and I'm addicted to Overwatch, and so many times.
In Puerto Rico, I want to say, encendiendo las luces! I wish I could have that. All of us would like that. I think the fans would tweet at Jeff Kaplan and Blizzard Entertainment. No, I think they know we all want that. It's just a matter of them figuring out stuff.
They have long-term plans, I think, for this game, for anything that they have there. They always do. They don't do anything small. And so they have a long game plan. So I have a feeling we'll be getting a lot of incarnations.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I'm sorry about your father's passing, but I'm so glad that Overwatch helped you through a tough time. That's great. Amazing.
Hello, my name is Carlos, and I'm a Humberman.
Yes!
Humber with a K.
Yes, with a K.
Yes.
My question is, you've both been in different games, both acting different characters. Carolina has acted in GTA 5, was Taliana. And Anjali was Nisha in Fallout 4. How did you get into the mindset of self different characters? Because like Nisha herself is really psychopathic, really obsessive about killing things. And you have to admit
that. Have you seen her? She is psychopathic. I mean, it's not hard.
And then you have to admit that it's more calculating, like more mellow. Sombra is more like, she wants her own things. Like, I want that. And Taliana is a bit like, I want things for her. So how do you get into that mindset? And if Symmetra had a car watch, what would the name be?
Wow, that's a good question. I'm going to answer the first one first, because that's easier, I think. Getting into the mindset of characters, whether as a voice actor or a screen actor or anything, because all of it is acting, all of it is storytelling. It's just what parts of you do you get to use, and how do we bring it to you guys, whether on screen or live or anything like that. For me, getting into the character is understanding how where they came from made them who they are, their own thought process, and making it logical. So Misha's background is actually not that unsimilar to Symmetra's. It's just that she went to the dark side, of course, immediately, right? And so that's kind of a classic example of what are you doing with the circumstances of your life, right? So I think that for grasping onto who a character is, I think that for me is always the insight. I'm gonna think about the car wash.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, for some characters, I don't have to think so much about it. It's more, well, I mean, as actors, we use our imagination constantly to make something up in order for it to work, but they didn't give me a lot of backstory for Taliana, so what's the situation right now? She's wounded, and she needs to drive somewhere and save herself. So, oh my god, what's it, you know, I've been shot at, and how? What happens? So, it's really, what would I do in this situation if this were happening, you know? I think that sometimes we think about our past. I grew up in Colombia, it was very dangerous when I was growing up there. Sombra has the same past, so I can connect to that. But I'm not a hacker, I don't have any idea how that works. So it's more like, if I could, what would I do with it? And so it really is just creating like a pretend life that we're living in. So it's a lot of imagination. And I like playing badass characters. Yeah.
All I can come up with right now is Dorit-mania.
Dorit-mania.
Come to Dorit-mania and get the 499 car wash.
Yeah, I mean, after this, cheap, yo!
Yes, but you'll never get your car back.
Okay, so I'm
thank you for your question, Carlos. I'm going to take 5 seconds to do a PSA before the next question. We have come to this amazing, I saw this on Instagram and I was so happy that I knew we were going to meet Edgardo Miranda Rodriguez here. He's the creator of La Borinqueña comic and its reconstruction. It's a play on words. I think it's so brilliant. A lot of the proceeds for this, if you buy this comic and the posters, is going to actual reconstruction of the island. And I'm going to tweet the crap out of this because I want mainland people and all over the world people to buy this so they can help you guys. But what's really cool is that it's really hands-on. He's not just donating to the UN and hoping that it gets here. He's been here figuring out where do you guys need help. They don't have midwives at a hospital, so all these women are coming together to help give birth because that's where help is needed. So I think it's a really beautiful project. I know Rosario Dawson is apoyándolo bastante. What's the word? Supporting. Thank you very much. Because Puerto Rico se levanta. And so don't check it out, give it some love. If you have Instagram and Twitter, share it because you guys need the help and we want to help and I just think this is so beautiful. It's just badass. La Borinqueña, you guys have a freaking Puerto Rican superhero. How amazing.
Okay, ta-da.
Hello, good morning. My name is Lou. I want to ask, how do you guys personally prepare yourselves before coming into a voiceover session? And what do you think are like some of the do's and don'ts of, you know, in a voice session?
She does. I've seen it. I drink the coffee while I watch her do the because I don't warm up like that. I think it's different again for every voice session and for every character. You definitely warm up your voice. That's the biggest thing. Like a singer, like an actor on stage or anything like that. Especially for games where you might be screaming a lot or doing death sounds and you need to make sure that everything is warm. But then also the physicality, like I don't, because Symmetra is such an even-keeled character, I spend more time in my head than like listening to music and doing stuff, like getting in the mind, like I'll get in the mind on my own because she's kind of more shut off to society, but normally I'll have music that I get into or physical warm-ups or whatever. And then the do's and don'ts are kind of like the do's and don'ts I feel like of any job. Be on time, be prepared, and don't be a... Is this a family show? Don't be a jerk. Let's put it that way. Be on time, be prepared, don't be a jerk.
Same. Voice warming up. Sombra's really low, which is great. So if it's a 10 a.m. session, I'm talking down here. It's not a problem for me.
But like when we got to be little kids and we know it's going to be like an hour and a half session.
I got to warm up because that is really tiring after a while. I always think like if I had to voice Diva, it would be so hard for me because I have a low voice, you know, she's really high. So, but yeah, sometimes like when we do a certain line, like the command lines that Sombra does, I stand up really straight and tall and like and plant my feet and go, you know, do this, do that. Moving the payload. I need some help over here, or whatever. Like, it's gotta be forceful, and so that helps. And, you know, I acted out the boop a million times because I felt like just doing boop is not the same as boop. So, you know, certain things we do physicalize, or when we're running, I run in place, or jump a little bit and try not to make noise around because they're recording. So, stuff like that are little tricks that we do, that just be on time.
Thank you.
Hello.
I'm a gay girl, also.
Yes. what world do you wish that you want to be in your life? Like, let's say the world of anime or video games or movies, TV shows. If it's anime, then which one and why?
I have never been able to pick in my entire lifetime, which is why I never have. Part of the joy of being an actor is that you have so many different worlds that you can be a part of, and the more you learn to do, the more you get to do. So I picking one is like picking your favorite children. Like I can't do it. It's one day I might be doing a musical, and one day I might be doing TV, and same for one day I might be doing voice acting, I might be shooting a film the next day, and that's the joy of it. So I don't think I could pick.
I think it was like pretend like if you could be an anime. Like, live in the world of anime.
Exactly, like,
yes.
If you want to, like, the world of video games.
Yeah.
Like, if it's video game, which type?
Like, how can you live, like, live in it?
Like,
sorry.
I want to live in Disney or Pixar world. Just because, like, that was fun. But I want to, like, Prince. Sure, I'll be a princess if Disney asks me to. But, like, I want to play characters like Timon and Pumbaa or Ohio. She's ready to answer it. She's going. Oh, my God. Yes, exactly. So I think it would be one of those, like,
I like playing little creatures and stuff.
Because those are more fun than, like, oh, I'm a princess in despair.
Harry Potter. But then I also don't want to be like bored. Obviously Harry and Hermione and everyone, they're awesome. But I don't want anyone to think that like I only have that side to me. I feel like in real life I would be chaotic good for you D&D players.
Yeah.
There's gotta be a little bit of an edge that says I follow the rules when they make sense.
Exactly.
But yeah. I think I'd have to choose Gryffindor just because ultimately they are aligned with good. And
yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Yeah. I'm just a humble Sin main. Which yes. Funny story? When Gaku Space came here, he asked me, "Oh, are you a Genki?" And I'm like, "No, I'm a Sin main." I'm like, "Oh, dude, that's," and I quote, "That is so gay, dude."
Gaku Space.
Yeah.
I challenge you, Gaku. I'm challenging you on everyone's iPhones right now. Come and get me, yo.
I always said it like Gaku. Oh, that was so good.
Yeah. Like after that, every time I play,
I'm Genji.
I dedicate myself to melting every Genji I see. It's
and that's only because Symmetra's Danger Noodle is like the total foil for Genji right now. So
that's why you see a Genji.
Who needs to deal? Who needs to deal? Sorry, dude. Don't hate the player. From here down, you look great. From here up, not so much. We like the bad 76.
We love Gaku, by the way.
We have so much fun with everyone in this game, which is why we give each other
massages.
We'll give each other crap.
Anyway, my question is more for Anjali. Is there a possibility?
Anjali. Let's all say it together.
Anjali!
Bokinze ina! Anjali!
I always think it's like Italian. Anjali, you know.
Is there a possibility for a Symmetra short in the future?
Oh, of course. I think every character at some point or another is going to be involved in the shorts, whether they're own or others. Again, I think there's a very long plan that Blizzard has, and they're going to be rolling out stuff and new characters and new lore and new events for years to come, and we're all going to try to keep up with them.
Hi, my name is Megan. I'm a gamer.
Please.
So,
birthday is today, say their name into your phone so they think we're saying their name. So we all get a recording by this whole room.
I want a two, I want two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Fallout, where everything is so dark and twisty, and I don't want to. I have no interest in living in that world. I want Overwatch's mindset to take over Fallout. And like Nisha and Symmetra to mate, and Symmetra like, dude, like, you can clean this up.
Yeah.
I don't want to like yours, but I can't see out of it. Don't make it make me mad. It's okay. Like, I'd love to see that take over that. I'd also like the puppy dragon from The Last Guardian to be part of Overwatch, because every game needs a puppy dragon. Every life needs a puppy dragon.
I need a puppy dragon.
You have a puppy dragon.
He's a puppy. He's not a dragon. I just dressed him up as a dragon.
Poor thing. I was going to say, I would love these two worlds to meet. Guardians of the Galaxy and Overwatch. Because they're a... Chris Pratt. No, Rocket! Because they are misfits, essentially. They come together to, like, create a little band. And we are a bunch of weirdos as well in Overwatch, with a lot of cool power. So I think that, like, they'd have a ball together, and they would save the world.
Yes! Okay.
So.
That's a much better... That's not
I just think they'd get along, because they're such crazy personalities. Catching up on these, baby.
Genius. No, genius. Hi.
Look at your ears. The Dark One, Slytherin baby. Was his name Malfoy? We would be like, come on.
That's tough for Symmetra, I think. She would be a Gryffindor in terms of her moral mindset, but I don't know. She might be more...
She would do her homework with Hermione.
She totally would do her homework with Hermione, so I feel like she's a slash between Gryffindor and Ravenclaw. Definitely not Hufflepuff, because the Hufflepuff, I feel like that would be more like, TARGAR! Would be all like, even Reinhardt, well, Reinhardt would be Gryffindor. I'm just going to keep going, but I'll stop.
Look at you, oh, beautiful.
This is kind of a strange way, because I think I figured it out like maybe 4 or 5 years ago, and I didn't really understand it. I didn't really understand that it was a journey. I'm going to do all of the emotional stuff. I'm going to go through the pain. I'm going to go through the happiness. I'm going to go through all of it for you. And at the end of the day, when we leave, you get to walk out of this theater, or you get to shut off your TV and go back to your life, safe and sound, but you will get... have a fuller emotional life for it. So for me, it was finding a way to use my creative powers for the powers of good rather than making up stories in my head and driving myself crazy. Just the fact that we can do that for other people is a really exciting thing and gives it a reason to just play pretend for a living, which seems silly and selfish. And crazy.
I
was just going to go again. Simpler. As a child, I couldn't stop screaming, and my mom was like, I need to make her do something to stop, so, no. I did audition for a play, though, when I was really young, when I was 5, because my mom was like, yeah, she's theatrical and dramatic, and then I got a play, and then I did it, and I'm like, oh my god, I love being on stage with other people, because I teach you so much, and I was just like, oh, I love this, so it's you know, exertion of a lot of energy and also, emotion. And then it became, oh, I like telling stories, and oh, what can we do with this? But as a child, it was just like, oh, that's my stage, you know?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. My name's Gabby, and my question is, what's the hardest part of your job?
Don't get the job. We have to have really thick skins, because it's like if you're going on a job interview for, you know, a graphic design job, and you go on not one interview, but 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, and you get one job, but the job only lasts a day, and then you have to go back on all those job interviews. So that's the story of our lives, is going on a gazillion auditions and booking one out of, I'm not kidding, like every 50 or more, you know? So most of the time, we're not getting the job, and we just have to keep telling ourselves, it's okay, we're gonna get one, and I'm talented enough, or I can do this without giving up. Because there were times when I was like, I hate my life, I'm not good enough, you know? Because you don't
succeed at the beginning so often, and then it becomes a little better. But I think that's the really hard part of it, is just staying true to yourself and knowing you love it enough to keep with it.
And piggybacking on that, for each audition, caring enough to put your best self out there and to put yourself completely into the character and the scene and the circumstance, and then as soon as the audition is done, letting it go.
Let it go!
No, don't do it! Don't do it! Don't do it! Don't do it!
I sing that all the time to her and she can't stand it.
Sing it, please!
Oh. Oh. Don't do it! Don't do it! Don't
do it! A one, a two, a three! Let it go! Let it go! Can't hold it back anymore! Let it go! Let it go! I'm going to it. Oh, sorry. I love you for it. You didn't want to overpower them.
How much do you love her?
I didn't see my... She was dead while I was doing that.
So I wish I could think of something specific. Although he was very good. Okay, so the second episode of the show that I did a show with him recently called Alex Inc. And I played his Bengali mother-in-law. We won't talk about the friends or anything like that. I won't talk about it. I don't speak Bengali. It's not my language. They were throwing some new lines at me in a very serious scene, like in a very big moment. And I kept trying to say them, and then having to stop, and trying to say them, and having to stop, and then the voice coach would say them, and I was trying, like I was just not getting it, because it was a new one. And he was like, I don't understand what the problem is. And then as she said it, he just mouthed it into the camera, as if he was saying, and he was like, see, I just did it. I just did it right there. Why was that so hard? And I was like, she said, I would have to put her there. How did I just talk about that? That was so easy. I don't understand what your problem was. So it made me laugh a lot, and it's probably funnier in the moment.
I think some of the things I've loved doing voice work, when we get to work in a booth with other actors, we don't do it for Overwatch, but sometimes when we do cartoon stuff, we get to work with the other actors.
And so, like, we need a kid voice, you know, and then they call cut, and somebody drops the mic, and they'll be like, oh, shit.
You know, and so when you say bad words in kid voices, it's hysterical. And so I feel like when they cut and stop recording, I'm waiting for something.
Oh man, this is ridiculous.
So, and then just conversations that happen in those funny voices, I think are just a really fun thing. Most of the time, because I'm working with way more talented people than myself, and they're doing amazing voices. So I feel like, for me, it's just, she's laughing.
I keep laughing because I keep thinking now that I have all these things that I can't share because they're not really family. But very specifically like that, when people are like, when you're doing voice acting for animation and stuff, And you're cracking up at the thing the person next to you is doing and trying so hard not to make any noise because they are so funny. I mean, that happens to me, like, with you in life. So,
hi! Hello. Cool shirt. Show everybody.
That does not speak and do it entirely word free you know, there's sounds, but it's word-free story and still manage to pull at your heartstrings like that. I love that. Love that.
I was going to say that one. I also love the latest Reinhardt one. So that's special. Darren, the voice of Reinhardt is amazing. He's so sweet. I think that... There's two Dia de los Muertos ones. I'm not crazy about the Aqua one. Like, whatever. It's cool. We're not that cool.
I think I feel the same way. This is purely because I'm like, oh, I can't cosplay that one, so I don't want to wear it. Is that there's a I don't know what the name of it is, but there's like a golden yellow Symmetra one, which would look great in League. It would look great. Yes. Looks great on her.
Yes.
I just don't think I can peel off that yellow.
Oh, no. We do a speed round.
Yeah.
We do a speed round. We got
two
against you guys.
Well, it's a super fast.
And
you got
super
fast.
Especially that.
Well, yes, there is. I have these postcards here for all of you to pick along with you. There's a show that is currently airing right now called Real Life Frontier. It's airing on ProjectAlpha.com, which is an offshoot of Geek and Sundry, where Matt Mercer does Critical Role and all those places. And the way I have been describing Real Life Frontier, but I don't know if they would sanction it, is if D&D and The Walking Dead had a baby, this would be the show. Come check it out. On the back of this is a coupon code. You can watch it for 60 days for free. There's a ton of great content on that channel. Please check it out. Please write to us. There's a Discord. So yes, that is that.
I think it's coming too, but it's called The Man of Darkness. It's a horror film, and it's going to be really, really good. It hasn't come out yet, but I will tweet at you when it's out, and it's going to be great. A horror film. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Joseph, and I'm a passionate Batman. What do you think about the new Symmetra changes coming to Overwatch?
I'm super excited.
Your cosplay's amazing!
Yes. Thank you for doing that. We saw you from afar on the line. Yeah, super excited about those changes. I think it's going to be really fun.
If you could voice act any character from any other franchise, who would you do?
Something to talk like this, because it's so different than my age, and I really don't want to remember you.
I don't know. I'm going to get back to you on that one. Superhero. I just don't know which one. New one. La Voy en Kenya.
What do you think is the reason that, unlike all other science fiction involving AI rebellions, somehow Overwatch of all universes develops a proper peace treaty?
Because in Overwatch, the whole goal is fighting for a world that's worth fighting for. And so they have figured out a way to develop peace amidst the fighting, because that is the main focus of the game by the game creators and Ben Stiller.
Thank you. Because honestly, I have nothing else to say.
Sorry.
How did you start with your attack
on Kirby? Oh, Jesus. That takes forever to answer.
You might need to come to the table to ask us that, because we're really old, and getting started in our acting career was a long time ago. We may not remember.
There are tons of videos online where we do talk about it, but we just hustled for years and years.
Hi, I'm David. I play, pretty much, who do you think is the most attractive character in Overwatch?
Attractive?
Wow.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Great.
I mean, that might be the dulcet tones of Matt Mercer's voice.
I know he's cutting you off. We said we were going to go fast because we're trying to get to all of you, so thank you for that. We apologize, but it's the only way to... We could have just ignored the 10 people that were going, so we're doing our best, guys. We're sorry.
So, changing mindsets between being extra happy in a character and suddenly going all seldom and quiet, lonely, how does that work?
It's different for every person because it's your own emotional journey, and it sounds really creepy, but our emotions are part of our instrument, and we need to learn to play our own emotions at the moment. For me, it's just genuinely 100% using my imagination to say, how would I react in this moment under these given circumstances?
Would any of you boop Reaper?
Like 1,000,000,000 times, are you kidding? Boop, 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 boop. Fuck the boop!
We're sorry we rushed through that last section.